Good afternoon. Next up is Thomas Hosede with Borderlands Granule Sequencer.
Hello. I will try to present you a software which is called Derrickland. You were expecting to have something called Borderland, but this morning I received an email from the author of the source project, which told me that he wanted to continue the project on iThings, you know, the things with an Apple inside, and he can't do open source anymore. So I have to change the name of the software today. So it's now called Derrickland. Some people know Derrick, you will see. So Derrickland is a granular sequencer. What is granular sequencing? It's a very, very, very old concept in music. It started in 1950. With mathematics and so on. It's a kind of a branch of electroacoustic music, and the philosophy is to prefer techniques and tools and so on better than aesthetics. That's not why you do awful things with it. So this kind of music will bring you your experience to real-time music. You cannot compose with it. And everything is based on the conception of grain. So you have small grain of music, not notes, you have just grain of music on which you play with it. It's quite weird, but I will show you, it will be there. So what is Derrickland? The project was originally developed by Chris Carlson and on for the end project of school, and then he continued the project for iPads. So, as you know, on App Store you can do open source projects and so on. So he led the project, the source of the project, in a very old version, and. As I found this really enthusiastic, I continue developing. So it's developed in C++ and OpenGL. You can try it on every platform, but in Linux it's better. Alors, Derrickland enables you to have a great freedom of creation because you don't have to have music theory. You don't have to learn something, you don't have to know the notes and so on. It's very intuitive. So you put and you play, and that sounds great. You have two forms, you place samples, you place grains, you place clusters, and you play everything, and you put, and you add some effects adding on this, and you have granular sequencing. As it's real time, it's really fun because every time you move something, you have a reaction, an audio reaction, and you can play. Some people are interested in this project to play music with children, with a person with a brain damage, and so on, because there is no need to learn something before. So this is a project originally designed. So you have the controller with the main brain of the application, and then you have two ways, the audio part and the visualizer part, the view engine, which renders the application on screen. And the code is really well done so that you can easily hack everything, which sound part or visual part. And what I added to the original project, improving the GUI, improving some things, adding some presets, adding some saving capabilities, and the thing I really, really wanted is to add a connection to the world. It means that you can plug some MIDI stuff like this stuff, a nano controller, you can plug to you, like your React app, React Vision, you can plug OSC, not yet, but in the future release, so you can play music with a smartphone or something. As a concept is quite weird, I will try to present you what you can do. Up. So, it works? Yeah. So, the concept, So you have some parts all over the screen that you can move everywhere on the screen. You can resize, you can rotate, and move, rotate, please, You won't rotate, but it, you can. And then when you put the sun, you put some clusters. A cluster is no more or less than... A cluster is a surface in which the grains appear randomly and when with a special long duration on some effects. And you could you can change the size, and you can put I try to do this. No more. And you could put as many clusters as you want. And when a grain touch a sample here, it becomes red and plays the sound, just a part of the sound. Yeah. So you have the sound played, and you can have after add effect. So to be easier, you can plug this kind of stuff, and you can play with the size and some other effects, like the volume, like overstepping. Each sound is played each time, or they can overlap one over another. You have the volume assay, the duration. Okay, each sound that it's 10 milliseconds per sample, and then you can move to longer. And then some LFO. So the first thing you do, it's quite difficult, or it's quite weird. The result is quite weird. But you can try to add some, you can move everything, so you will really rapidly, quickly, try to move the sounds to have something interesting. You have to check. And you try to move every button and everything. The best way to use this is to have a React table. It's a huge table with a video projection. Stop it. 1 second. You can React table, which is a table on which you place things that are recognized by a webcam put under. And then when you put things, you move the sounds. It's the best way to use it. And I don't have the time to bring a table, but I have a virtual table. So you have to imagine it's a table. And you have here things that you bring and you put on the table. So I will move it off ground. Changing presets. So I have my screen. Okay. So you have to, and I bring some stuff here on the table, and it totally crashed, totally normal. It's still in beta, and it's always work. It's an unstable branch, and unstable is not stable by definition. But you can use it; it's very, very fun. You can store sound sample, WAV files, or AIF file in folders, and you put your collections. You like here, for example, I have all this dance with some samples here, and you can change to have, for example, another sounds folder on green collection. And if you find something great, it is don't move it. I like it this way. You can store settings. So I have to write somewhere it is stored, and then when you move, or if you had a mistake, you can call back. It doesn't work. You can call back settings to bring them back to bring every elements with every settings, everything at its place. It doesn't work really like I want because I worked it 1 hour just before arriving. And you've got a really nice basis. The main idea of the project is to be continued and to be fork or something like that by everyone who wants to bring. There is a lot of stuff to add. You can improve graphics, you can improve audio effects, you can add effects. We can add something very boring, documentation. Encore la fin, ouais. Hop. Ça c'est fait. We can add settings, we can add everything, you can add controller, we can add interface to manage controllers, and we want to conquer the world by telling the music is okay. With some other artists, we managed to add, we had some performances on in clubs and so on with this kind of music, and people were very pleased by the result of the sound because it's totally new. It has 50 years old, but it's totally new, and it's really pleasant. Some people, as I told you, with little children that don't know music, they love a lot this kind of tool because they will be able to manipulate sounds directly with some cubes. Everything is possible with this software, and it has a huge potential. So I can invite you to use it, fork it, manage it. The source is not available. Yes, it is. You can get the source on Gitorius and bring everything you want. The name will change, as you told you, because Chris Carlson prefers to go to the dark side of the code. And that's it. You can have fun with it and play and do whatever you want. If you have any question or something, I can agree. No? Perfect.
How's the mini mapping done?
Sorry?
How's the mini mapping done? Did you use a controller, but you need some settings to...
Yes. In fact, settings are, for now, a little bit hard-coded. MIDI has been added 1 week ago, and I didn't take time to add an interface. I have to do an interface to plug a thing, because if you have two controllers, only one will be recognized. So, if you want, you can. It's free. It's open. if you know someone that can do it, just tell it. That's it. Perfect. Right. Thank you.